Hey guys, today we will see some missing features. So I will explain a few of the features in this tutorial. And for that, I have generated this geometry. So we will start from geometry and then we will do mesh and complete one static analysis for this. Okay, so we'll start from geometry from XY plane. First I'll change the units, then rectangle, extrude, air frozen. And then 10 mm. It looks okay. Generate. This is a rectangle. Now I'll sketch on Y and Z plane. Y and Z plane. Okay. Z plane sketching polylines. Yeah, so this is sketch. Now if you closely look, it is working fine. Everything is horizontal and vertical. Yeah. Now generate. I'll use the revolve operation for this geometry. This will be your axis and generate 360. I need to do air frozen. That's good. Now we have this geometry. Our next operation I will use boolean. Boolean subtract target bodies, tool bodies, preserve tool bodies, generate. Now it is deleted, so I will hide the second part. Yes, then I will quit, delete face, delete, generate. Okay, then show this body, and then I will again use boolean subtract. Now this will be a target, this will be a tool, resort to bodies, generate. Yeah, so now this is our final geometry. Let's say this is our final geometry. Okay. This is actually two different solids. Then I'll go to the measure. For that I will do the static structural simulations. I add the geometry with the geometry. Yeah, these are combined now. Open the model. Okay, now this is, we got this geometry now here. Okay, I will just generate a default mesh. Generate mesh. If you look at the mesh, there is a different mesh. The nodes are not common in this meshes on solid. Like mesh on this solid is not connected to mesh on this solid, and there is now you can see ANSYS has automatically detected a contact, and this solid contact surfaces are shown here, and solid is in contact with second solid, and these are second solid's contact surfaces. Like that, ANSYS has automatically detected the contact, and the mesh is not sharing a common nodes. Suppose if you want that the mesh should share the common nodes, for that you need to go to design modeler. On the design modeler, and go to these parts. We have these solids. I have picked these two solids by pressing Control key, and I will right click here, and then I will pick the for new part. So these two solids are now in a single part. I'll minimize this, I'll close this, and then reopen. It is saying that upstream geometry is changed, so you need to load a new data. New geometry will load. Now you see there is progress in attachment, and this is a part test shown the contacts, but there are no contacts are generated by ANSYS. Then if I generate a mesh, you will see that there is connection, there is a nodes which are common. So this is a continuous mesh. Now both parts are now in a single mesh. We need a continuous mesh. If I hide this part, you can see this circle, this second part circle. If I show body and hide this body and show the mesh, so this is actually we have generated a mesh with common nodes between solids. Now after knowing all these things, I would like to discuss some mesh features. Like if I click on the mesh, it is showing that it is a mechanical problem. I can also choose the CFD, electromagnetic, non-linear mechanics. Accordingly, it will change the mesh preferences. So this is a mechanical problem. So here there are different options: adaptive proximity, curvature proximity. So can tell the measure that whenever there is a curvature or proximity, macro means mesh more dense. Now this is a relevant center. If I change it to medium and then I generate the mesh, you see it will now place a little fine mesh. Okay, and all these other options like element size is default, mesh defeaturing, transition is how mesh grows from, suppose I have 1 mm element here and I have 4 mm element here. Like I have told ANSYS to place 4 mm element here and 1 mm element here, then how it is going to propagate. The ratio between the element size, like it is 1 mm, then it is 1.2 mm, like that it will keep growing. So if I say slow transition, then ratio will be small. If I select fast, then ratio between sizing up the nearest elements will be very very large. You can define this ratio also. You can tell ANSYS how much ratio you should keep. But all these things I will discuss in detail in some other tutorials. Now in this I'm going to show you sizing. Sizing we can define for point, line, face, or for entire body. Like if you see the mesh here now, I will hide this part. And if I say I want more number of elements at this face, if you see the mesh, it is a very coarse here. I can tell it to place more number of elements or finer element sides. So I can say it's 0.5 mm. If you see the circle which is shown there, the cross mark, the cross lines in the circle, the circle actually shows the size of the element. I will say make it a 1 mm, so now it is bigger. So if I generate a mesh on this solid body only, generate mesh on selected bodies, you will see that it has kept a finer elements here. Now you can also do the same sizing about a point. Like if I want finer elements near this point, if I choose this, it will ask for the sphere of influence. So I will say 5 mm. Now it has shown the sphere. So in this sphere, it will place the element size, which is 0.5 mm. Then if I generate a mesh on this body, you see the effect of this point size. You can see how it is. Now if you see here, it has placed very fine elements and the growth is faster. Let me change it as a slow transition. I will generate a mesh. The effect is that now it has Chrome with lesser size ratio. If you see, this is actually face sizing, vertex sizing. You can also provide sizing online and sizing on solid. If you provide sizing on solid, then inside in the core of the solid, it will follow that size. It will try to follow that size. It's not necessary that it will follow that size, because it is not possible to fulfill all the constraints. Then it will pop up the warning that this sizing is not followed. Now this will finish the introduction to the measure. I will explain about other features of the measure in coming tutorials. It is a very big topic, so it will need a lot of tutorials. So this tutorial I will now finish this tutorial. Thank you.